to St John's Church for our annual Benefice Carol Service. And on our behalf, can I extend a welcome and our thanks to John Bodiley on the organ, for the Bristol Brass Consort, the Benefice Choir, and Mark Goddard for bringing all our musical worship together. And a huge thank you also to everyone who's made this service possible and contributed in any way. There won't be any other announcements you'll be pleased to hear throughout the service. It follows a traditional pattern of sitting for the reading, apart from the seventh, the gospel, where we'll stand, and standing for the carols. There will be a retiring collection in aid of the church owners' charity. And so let's start our carol service by singing, O come, Emmanuel.
Thank you. remember the birth of Jesus, that we may share in the song of the angels, the gladness of the shepherds, and worship of the wise men. Close the door of hate, and open the door of love all over the world. Let kindness come with every gift, and good desires with every greeting. Deliver us from evil by the blessing which Christ brings, and teach us to be merry with clear hearts. May the Christmas morning make us happy to be thy children, and Christmas evening bring us to our beds with grateful thoughts, forgiving and forgiven. For Jesus' sake, amen.
Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it. mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice says, cry out. And I said, what shall I cry? All people are grass. Their constancy is like the flower of the field. The grass withers, the flower fades, when the breath of the Lord blows upon it. Surely the people are grass. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God will stand forever. Get you up to a high mountain, O Zion, herald of good tidings. Lift up your voice with strength, O Jerusalem, herald of good tidings. Lift it up, do not fear. Say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. See, the Lord God comes with might, and his arm rules for him. His reward is with him, and his recompense before him. He will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs in his arms, and carry them in his bosom, and gently lead the mother sheep. Thanks be to God.
Prophet Micah speaks of the birth of the Messiah in Bethlehem. But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labour has brought forth. the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth. Thanks be to God.
Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him
his kingdom there will be no end. Mary said to the angel, how can this be, since I am a virgin? And the angel said to her, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her, who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God. Then Mary said, here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word. Then the angel departed from her. Thanks be to God.
Oh, great. Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favours." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing which has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds had told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. Thanks be to God.
Magi are led by bright star to Jesus. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophets. And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word, so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they'd heard the king, they set out, and there, ahead of them, went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left their own country by another road. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
incarnation of the Word of God. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. True light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of the Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. Thanks be to God.
Wonderful to see you all this evening. And we've been spotting some Christmas jumpers as well. Fantastic. It is great that we can have time like this to come together and celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Saviour. And we celebrate by singing and listening to wonderful carols, as well as hearing God's salvation plan, which came to fulfillment in the person of Jesus Christ. Christmas is a time of real celebration, but I'm aware that it doesn't happen in a vacuum. Life still goes on with all its challenges. And for me, the trick is to try to allow the joy of Christmas to penetrate the everyday experience. Easier said than done, I know. But for me, the joy of Christmas isn't found in fleeting sentiment or materialism. The joy of Christmas is founded in hope. The hope that springs from the reading from John's Gospel when he writes, "A light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it." The light of Jesus goes deeper and higher and wider than any human can imagine. Even the darkest places are not impenetrable to that light. Earlier in the service, we sang, "It came upon a midnight clear." And when I looked at the verses again, verse 3 really did jump off the page at me, because it speaks into our real world existence. "And man at war with man hears not the love song which they bring. Oh, hush the noise, ye men of strife, and hear the angels sing." Man at war with man hears not. It's so easy to drown out that joyous message of Christmas with so much going on. With challenges, with wars, with distractions. And an occasion such as this one gives us the time and the space to stop and to listen again for the love song which the angel brings. Oh, hush the noise. and hear the angels sing. And that angel song is one of hope and light, come into the world at the first Christmas, but also into our hearts this very evening. The light of the world is within our reach. And if, like me, you're a Pre-Raphaelite fan, you might have seen this painting by Holman Hunt. It's Jesus, the light of the world. And it comes from the Revelation passage. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. And Jesus is holding a light. And he's knocking on the doors to our hearts. But if we only open it a crack, that light will only go in a small way. The more we open our hearts to the light of Jesus Christ, the more that light floods into our lives. Doesn't necessarily mean that all things will be rosy, but what it does mean is that that light of Jesus can shine into dark places and shine light and hope. Oh, hush the noise, ye men of strife, and hear the angels sing. That song from God the Father says, I love you. I sent my Son to die for you. Don't fill your lives with noise that drowns me out. I want you to be at peace. I want to comfort you. I want to be with you. All we need to do is open the door of our hearts to the light of Christ. And I pray that you will experience this Christmas like never before the light of Jesus Christ and the hope that that brings. So, a very happy Christmas to you all. And I do pray that you will be truly blessed this Christmas. Amen.
Amen.
So let's pray. To the bidding, when I say Jesus, Saviour, please respond with hear our prayer. So let us pray to Jesus, our Saviour, Christ, born in a stable. This night, give courage to all who are homeless, to the refugee, to those displaced by war, to the unloved or marginalized. Jesus, Saviour, hear our prayer. Christ, for whom the angels sang, give the joy of hope to all who weep or who are distressed this night. For those who are sick, those who are frightened or alone, Jesus, Saviour, hear our prayer. Christ, worshipped by the shepherds, give peace on earth to all who are oppressed and all who suffer at the hands of others. Jesus, Saviour, hear our prayer. Christ, for whom the wise men knelt, give humility and wisdom to all who govern, to all who make decisions on our behalf, and to those who serve us. Jesus, Saviour, hear our prayer. Christ, whose radiance filled a lonely manger, give the glory of your resurrection to all who rest in you. Jesus, Saviour, has joined together with the words of the Lord's Prayer in traditional forms. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
May the Father, who has loved the eternal Son, and before the foundation of the world, shed that love upon you, his children. Amen. May Christ, who by his incarnation gathered into one things earthly and heavenly, fill you with joy and peace. Amen. May the Holy Spirit, by whose overshadowing Mary became the God-bearer, give you grace to carry the good news of Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you and those you love and pray for this day, this night, and always. Amen. We stand for our final carol.
Thank you. Thank you.